like giving it away. So the first couple of years, I made my own costumes, which of course suck. The ghost, the hobo, no good. Then finally, third year, begging the parents, got the Superman Halloween costume, not surprisingly. Cardboard box, cellophane top, mask included. Remember the rubber band on the back of that mask? That was a quality item there, wasn't it? That was good for about 10 seconds before it snapped out of that cheap little staple they put it in there with. You go to your first house, trick or snap, it broke, I don't believe it. Wait up, you guys, I gotta fix it. Hey, wait up! Wait up! That's what kids say, they don't say wait. They say, wait up! Hey, wait up! Because when you're little, your life is up, the future is up, everything you want is up. Wait up, hold up, shut up. Mom, I'll clean up, let me stay up. Parents, of course, are just the opposite. Everything is down, just calm down. Slow down. Come down here, sit down, put that down. So I had my little costume, I was physically ready, I was preparing myself. I did not try on the costume prior to Halloween. Do you remember this? This is an obscure one, but on the side of the box, I remember this, on my Superman costume, it actually said, do not attempt to fly. They printed that as a warning, because kids were putting it on and going off the roofs. You know. I love the idea of the kid who's stupid enough to think he actually is Superman, but smart enough to check that box before he goes off the roof. Wait, let me see if it says anything about me being Superman. Oh, wait a second here, So anyway, but my hopes were up. I was thinking that this is probably the same exact costume that Superman wears himself. And you put these things on, it's not exactly the super fit that you are hoping for. It looks more like Superman's pajamas is what it looks like. It's all kind of loose and flowing, and the neckline kind of comes down about there. Flimsy little ribbon string in the back. Plus, my mother makes me wear my winter coat over the costume anyway. I don't recall Superman wearing a jacket. Not like I had cheap corduroy phony fur. Boy, I'm Superman, but it's a little chilly out, and I'm glad I've got this cheap little 10-year-old kid's jacket. So I'm going out, I'm trick-or-treating, but the mask, the rubber band keeps breaking, it keeps getting shorter. I'm fixing it, it's getting tighter and tighter on my face. You know when it starts slicing into your eyeballs there, and you're trying to breathe through that little hole? Getting all sweaty. I can't see, I can't breathe, we gotta keep going, we gotta get the candy! And a half hour into it, you just take that mask, oh, the hell with it! Bing bong, yeah, it's me, give me that candy. Yeah, I'm Superman, look at the pant legs, what do you care? Remember those last couple of years, trick-or-treating, getting a little too old for it? Still out there, going through the motions. Bing bong, come on, lady, let's go. Halloween doorbells, candy, let's pick it up in there. Come to the door, they always ask you those same stupid questions. What are you supposed to be? I'm supposed to be done by now. You want to move it along with the Three Musketeers? I got 18 houses on this block, sweetheart. Just hit the bag, we hit the road. That's the way it works. Sometimes they give you that little white bag twisted on the top. You know, that's going to be some crap candy. Doesn't have the official Halloween markings on it. Hold it, lady. Wait a second. What is this? The orange marshmallow shaped like a big peanut? Do me a favor. You keep that one. Yeah, we have all the doorstops we need already. Thank you. We're going for name candy only this year.
And that, my friends, concludes the Friday Funnies with funny man Jerry Seinfeld on the program. Jerry Seinfeld talking about Halloween. Now, let's find out what's on the old television for tonight and what's on the big screen this weekend. a little segment that I like to call What's on TV Tonight. Pretty clever, isn't it? I thought so. Anyway, so without further delay, okay, let's wrap this thing up. Need to find a shorter outro. Okay, here we go. And now, let's find out what's on TV for tonight. Oh, hold on a minute. If I'm going to read the list, I might as well turn the Nook Reader on first. Okay, now we're ready. Pardon me. And, of course, you have to look up the times yourself, because I was too lazy to fix the computer glitch to do this. My apologies. But the 2013 NASCAR Camping World Truck Series, Winstar World Casino 350 from the Texas Motor Speedway in Fort Worth, Texas. Sweet Jesus, Mother of God. Ah, that was a long one. It's on Fox Sports today. Dallas Cowboys cheerleaders making the team. Season 8 finale on CMT. Time of Death series premiere on Showtime. The Dead Files. Season 4 premiere on the Travel Channel. It Takes a Choir series premiere on USA. Can we say Glee by another name? Kendra on Top. Season 2 finale on WE. I can make a really bad joke about that, but I won't. And Storage Wars New York Season 2 fall premiere tonight on A&E. Movie releases this weekend includes Ender's Game, rated PG-13. And Last Vegas, rated PG-13. And Freebirds, rated PG. All on the big screen. Come up tomorrow, it's All Souls Day. And a reminder, don't forget to set your clock back an hour before you head to bed Saturday night or / Sunday morning, because daylight saving time comes to an end at 2 o'clock local time. The first time, not the second time or third time. Because if you keep setting your clock back an hour, eventually you're just going to stay in Sunday. Which in some instances wouldn't be too bad. It's also Zero Tasking Day on Sunday. It's a day designed to dedicate this hour to me time, encouraging rest, relaxation, and a distinct lack of work. And it's also National Housewives Day and National Sandwich Day. So, what better way to honor a housewife than with a sandwich, right? Okay, that is why I'm single. Well, that's one of the reasons. That's going to do it for the program this week. Wish to thank my sponsors. They include Wishing Stars Native Creations, Maria Sewer with Fine Art Today, as well as ClassicPatioChairs.com, where you'll find Marshall Woodworking. You can find those sponsors, plus a whole lot of other sponsors, on the Friends page of my website, tinyurl.com/Gunther's House or /Gunther Mobile. Send me your emails to gunthershouseoffriends@gmail.com or leave me a message on Skype at G800-486-8437. That's G800-486-8437. Also, you can follow me on Twitter at jhafner99. That's the letter J, H-A-F-F-N-E-R, the number 99, jhafner99. Plus, see what else. Got the websites. Yes, the Stitcher app. You can listen to previous episodes of the show by downloading the Stitcher app, which is available on Stitcher.com or go to the opening page of my website, as well as on Spreaker at Spreaker.com. Be heard, Spreaker.com, and look for Gunther's House of Friends. Okay? That's going to do it for the show this week. I'll be back again on Monday with another edition, another rollicking edition of First Cup. Come up on Monday, of course, will be the usual features, along with the President's Weekly Radio Address, which can be heard on a lot of your AM stations tomorrow morning. But I'll have that repeat again coming up on Monday. And a week from Sunday, November 10th, at 6 p.m. that night, Central Standard Time, we'll be going back in time for Joe's Retro Radio, episode number 2. And next week, the next program, will feature shows dedicated to veterans, honoring troops of ages past, namely old USO tours, and looking forward to that program. Programs like Jack Benny, Red Skelton, Burns and Allen. You'll get the idea. Anyway, enough of my pedantic rambling, so let's switch music beds here. And a reminder that no one ever said life was going to be easy, but then nothing worthwhile ever is. Try and do the right thing, my friends. Be true to your heart, but most of all, I implore you to treat others with respect and kindness. Because we're in this ride of life together, and if one of us falls out of the boat, let's hit and lend a helping hand and pull them back in, okay? What's good as being right if you don't have any friends, okay? I'll catch you on the flip-flop. See you next week. Live long and prosper. Was produced by Joe Hafner. To hear more of my podcast, check out my website, tinyurl.com/Gunther's House. Gunther, go to the house.